Officer Edwards, I want to start by thanking you for your service and thank you for your courage. Thank you for being here this evening. I know that it's not easy to relive what happened for you and for the officers behind you and for the family members of officers in the audience this evening. But it's really important for the country to have a full accounting and understand what happened. I want to start, Officer Edwards, with a short clip that shows the horrible moment when you were injured as the peace circle was breached. Officer Edwards, can you describe the crowd that had assembled at the Peace Circle as you and your fellow officers stood behind and guarded the bike racks at the Peace Circle?
Yes, so there were about, I want to say, about five of us on that line. And there were, so there was our bike rack, and then at the bottom of the Pennsylvania Avenue walkway, or right by Peace Circle, there was another bike rack. And so the crowd had kind of gathered there. It was the crowd led by Joseph Biggs. And they were mostly in civilian clothes. There were some who had military fatigues on. We could see people with bulletproof vests on, you know, things like that. They didn't seem, you know, extremely cohesive, but they had gathered there in their outfits, but they had gathered there together, and Joseph Biggs started, he had a megaphone, and he started talking about, you know, first it was things kind of relating to Congress, and then the tables started turning once the, what is now the Arizona group is what you said, the crowd with orange hats, they came up chanting F-U-C-K, Antifa, and they joined that group. And once they joined that group, Joseph Biggs' rhetoric turned to the Capitol Police. He started asking us questions like, you didn't miss a paycheck during the pandemic, mentioning stuff about our pay scale was mentioned, and, you know, started turning the tables on us. And I've worked, I can, you know, conservatively say probably hundreds of civil disturbance events. I know when I'm being turned into a villain, and that's when I turned to my sergeant and I stated the understatement of the century. I said, Sarge, I think we're gonna need a few more people down here. And so after that, you know, I think they started conferring. They went a little silent. They started conferring among each other. I saw the person now identified as Ryan Samsel. He put his arm around Joseph Biggs, and they were talking, and then they started approaching the first barricade. They ripped the first barricade down, and they approached our bike racks. You know, at that time, we started holding on, grabbing the bike racks. You know, there weren't many of us, so I grabbed the middle between two different bike racks. And, you know, I wasn't under any pretense that I could hold it for very long, but I just wanted to, you know, make sure that we could get more people down and get our CDU units time to answer the call. So we started grappling over the bike racks. I felt the bike rack come on top of my head, and I was pushed backwards, and my foot caught the stair behind me, and I my chin hit the handrail, and then I, at that point, I had blacked out, but my the back of my head clipped the concrete stairs behind me.
And you were knocked unconscious, is that right, Officer Edwards?
Yes, ma'am.
But then when you regained consciousness, even with the injuries, you returned to duty, is that right?
Yes, ma'am. You know, at that time, adrenaline kicked in. I ran towards the west front, and I tried to hold the line at the Senate steps at the Lower West Terrace. More people kept coming at us. It just seemed like, you know, more and more people started, you know, coming onto the west front. They started overpowering us. And that was right about when MPD's officers showed up. Their bike officers pushed the crowd back and allowed our CDU units, as well as theirs, to form that line that you see, that very thin line between us and the protesters or the rioters, you know, at that time. I fell behind that line, and for a while, I started decontaminating people who had gotten sprayed and treating people medically who needed it.
And then you were injured again there on the West Terrace. Is that right, Officer Edwards?
Yes, ma'am. So after a while, I got back on the line. It was on the house side of the Lower West Terrace. And I was holding that line for a while. There weren't many of us over there. And Officer Sicknick was behind me for most of the time, for about 30 to 45 minutes that I was down there. We were just, as the best we could, we were just, you know, grappling over bike racks and trying to hold them as quick as possible. All of a sudden, I see movement to the left of me, and I turned, and it was Officer Sicknick with his head in his hands, and he was ghostly pale, which I figured at that point that he had been sprayed, and I was concerned. My you know, cop alarm bells went off, because if you get sprayed with pepper spray, you're going to turn red. He turned just about as pale as this sheet of paper. And so I looked back to see what had hit him, what had happened, and that's when I got sprayed in the eyes as well. I was taken to be decontaminated by another officer, but we didn't get the chance because we were then tear gassed.
And we are going to play just a brief clip of that moment that you've just described, Officer Edwards. Officer Edwards, I just want to thank you for being here, and I know, again, how difficult it is. I know the family of Officer Sicknick as well, who's here tonight. One of the things one of the Capitol Police officers said to me recently was to ask me whether or not, as members of Congress, all of us understood that on that day, on January 6th, when we were evacuated from the chamber, were led to a safe, undisclosed location, whether we knew that so many of you had rushed out of the building and into the fight. And I can assure you that we do know that. and that we understand how important your service is. Thank you for your continued work with our committee and the interviews, and thank you very much for both of you for being here this evening. Mr. Chairman, I yield back.
Thank you very much. Ms. Edwards, can you give us one memory of that awful day that stands out most vividly in your mind?
I can. That time when I talked about falling behind MPD's line, I remember because I had been kind of shielded away because I was holding those stairs, so I wasn't able to really see what was going on over here. When I fell behind that line and I saw, I can just remember my breath catching in my throat, because what I saw was just a war scene. It was something like I had seen out of the movies. I couldn't believe my eyes. There were officers on the ground. They were bleeding. They were throwing up. I saw friends with blood all over their faces. I was slipping in people's blood. I was catching people as they fell. It was carnage. It was chaos. I can't even describe what I saw. Never in my wildest dreams did I think that as a police officer, as a law enforcement officer, I would find myself in the middle of a battle. I'm trained to detain, a couple of subjects and handle a crowd, but I'm not combat trained. And that day, it was just hours of hand-to-hand combat, hours of dealing with things that were way beyond any law enforcement officer has ever trained for. And I just remember that moment of stepping behind the line and just seeing the absolute war zone that the West Front had become.
Let me thank you for your service and obviously your bravery that you have told the world about tonight. It's unfortunate that you had to defend the Capitol from fellow Americans. None of us would ever think that that would have to happen, but it did.